early on in my career, a bat flew into the AT&T Center and paused the game for a moment while it flew around, and then it left. And at that moment, I thought, I need to be prepared for this next time. I go to Academy, I buy a fishing net, I'm gonna come out as Batman, I'm gonna catch a bat. 09, a bat comes onto the court.
And if you look ahead, Martin.
And the bat's leading the break. Here's the outlet pass, there's the bat. There's a coyote.
Problem is, the game was going on, so players are on the court, so I can't go on the court, but I'm on the sideline, like, just waiting for the, I'm so excited.
Manu's tired of that stinking delay.
The bats are an interesting phenomena here at the AT&T Center. So the bats live on our grounds year-round and mostly within the rodeo barns and buildings. So as the rodeo's disrupting them, they are coming into our building.
The Spurs are back home at the AT&T Center on this Halloween evening. They welcome the Sacramento Kings to town. It's the Spurs and the Kings, and we have it for you right here.
We were playing against the Kings, and this bat was interrupting the game.
And how about that? We have a bat in the arena on Halloween.
Yes, we do.
I remember the frustration of Manu Ginobili because play kept stopping.
The bat is flying around the court. I mean, this is Halloween. I can't believe this. This is right on cue. Where's the bat? Where's the coyote? He always has a net for this situation.
Every game. This Batman costume and this net come out with me, and I fold it and I set it on the floor, waiting for this moment.
Coyote's chasing them with a big fish net. We're all got towels.
There's a coyote.
Appropriately dressed. And this is absolute perfect coincidence.
I mean, you're not going to see the bat on Christmas.
And, you know, I wasn't afraid of the bat, and I see all the other players going, they're trying to run to the locker room.
Oh, how hysterical. You see all these guys look big and tough, and this little furry creature comes zooming by their head. They're ducking.
It looked to me like Manu was just getting fed up with the whole thing. He was tired of the stoppages. He wanted to play basketball.
Easy one from DeJuan Blair, and here's the bat.
Oh, Manu knocked it out of midair! Manu had enough! And he will walk it off the floor. We've had towels, nets, and all we needed was Manu. Is there nothing he can't do?
I mean, the guy was interrupting our game, man. I want to play. When he came close, I just swatted. And I don't know how, but I got him.
One, that is incredible that he was able to just kind of line it up like a cat and grabbed it.
Unbelievable instincts and coordination. I don't know. He's not a human. He's crazy.
You know, back in Argentina, that's what we all do. Hunt bats, our hobby.
First bat delay that I've ever experienced. I don't know about you.
First time. I said you can watch 1,000 sporting events. You're never going to see anything like that.
Really not.
He has never ceased to amaze me the years he's been here, and he just did it again. The legend grows on Halloween night. I mean, like there's no way it can't happen. You'd call somebody a liar if they told you that story.
And then, of course, he picked it up, which probably wasn't the best thing to do, and he handed it to the usher.
He went backstage, everybody clapped, we finished the game, and then we find out when the bat got backstage, it had woken up and flew away. So now you can't test the bat, so there's no way to find out if it had rabies or not. Then the second thing that goes through my mind as well, it looks like I'm gonna be spending some time with him getting rabies shots.
After that game, we won the game, and I get the call from Will Sevening first, saying
the main thing is we got to make sure that you don't have it, and this is what we're doing. When I told him, he looked at me like, are you crazy? And there's no way. I mean, the odds are so low, and he went through this big mathematical formula. He's very good at math, and I'm not, but
30 minutes later, the doctor calls.
We had to take the precautions under the guidance of the San Antonio Health Department to have him go through the series of rabies vaccinations.
You don't want rabies, so I spent, I want to say we went 3 or 4 times, weeks apart.
Some were in the butt, and a few were in the belly.
Manu's very analytical with numbers, and he goes, well, the percentage that I have it is extremely low, but if you have it, it doesn't end well. So I had to take him to get shots, kicking and screaming for the most part.
I'm not sure. I deleted from my mind.
For the rabies, be careful, you know, rabies is a dangerous disease. And, you know, I had to get them. I talked to a lot of specialists and I had 12 cc's of vaccines in my body right now. So I think I'm going to be safe, but it's not something fun to do. So kids, don't do it at home. Don't handle it. Bats, don't swat them. Don't do anything, or raccoons, because you're going to end up like me.
I just never thought about all the shots and all the repercussions and the medical calls.
He had to do so many tests that he was like joking, like, I will never touch a bat again.
Now you see Manu.
And it was on every highlight show known to man.
He then picks it up and carries it off the court to thunderous cheers. He says, you know, when you can't dunk anymore, you have to find a way to make it into the news.
Early years of YouTube, and I think that's my most viewed play. More than a dunk or a game winner, it was the bat.
He justifiably deserves the nickname Batman.
My shoulders just fall. And I trudge back to the Coyote Den, take Batman off, fold it up, and set it back on the floor. Like, I missed my opportunity.
As the Spurs,
and the Coyote,
he's ready this time.
He's ready tonight. Get him!
Oh! Oh! One more attempt! Yes! Oh, the Coyote got him. Go ahead and chow down, Coyote.
The legend of Manu continues to grow.